Hey everybody, welcome to the Sneaky Weasel Direct Motocross post-race chat here. It's Billy Rainford here from Direct Motocross with
Greg Poisson.
Greg Poisson, the fish over there. But what we're going to do is we're going to start off by talking about the 250s, what went down over the three motos here at Sandalee. As we always start off, it is the Sneaky Weasel post-show, so cheers. Thanks to Sneaky Weasel.
Thank you.
And cheers. Okay, a few things to talk about. I mean, obviously, we always start with the weather. Crazy, clear all week, rains every weekend here. That's just the way 2020 is going. Feels about right.
Pretty much, yeah. It just seems like it's they're trying to help out with the watering system, I guess, but they always just seem to overdo it.
Just a little bit, but so Saturday for one moto of the pros, it was muddy. The guys packed the track down very solidly, so it was actually quite raceable.
Yeah, it looked all right from what I saw. It was I wasn't here Saturday, but definitely seemed like it was pretty good. I heard some mixed reviews from guys saying that yesterday was a little bit better. I think it was because it was packed and it didn't have as much time to soak through all the different layers that is Sandalee. So
right, yeah, some people, I mean, we talked to you can watch obviously all the interviews that we did, post-race interviews that Greg and I both went around and did. A lot of guys were mentioning became a bit one-lined. I mean, you kind of come sweeping through the corners, it kind of pushes stuff and makes it a bit difficult to pass, some people said, but hey man,
That's racing.
And so yesterday, rain. Today, rain stopped, sun came out. Track was a little bit tough at first. Became perfect by the afternoon.
Yeah, I was pretty jealous by the time 450 Moto 1 came around that the track was looking pretty good at that point. Still a little deep, but it definitely looked really good and just got better as the day went on. So the dirt was absolutely primo everywhere, I'd say. And then the guys got cleaner as the day went on.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, let's take a look at the top 10 in the 250 class. 10th was number 32, that's William Crete. I saw him in practice, and I couldn't see a number because it was such a mess. The kid is looking faster and faster all the time. And I talked to him, and I said, man, you're looking faster. And he said, thank you. And he had a great day, ended up 10th overall.
Yep, that's your guy, Bill Crete. You're always telling me to look out for him, and he's definitely super solid. Seems like he'll be getting closer to the top five. Deschambault, we'll see how it goes.
Yep, seems like the tougher the conditions, the better he's doing. So I've just been impressed and watching some of these kids that we've known for a long time, and suddenly they've found another gear and are kind of moving up through the ranks. So it's cool to see that anyway. So ahead of him, number 41, Jeremy Mackay, rookie pro. The kid is coming into his own.
Yep.
Had some troubles, had some great races. Man, he's looking good.
Looked solid all day. There's not really much to say good or bad. He seemed to be doing really well and learning the series, learning the speed as he goes, and I'm sure that national number will get better too for next year as we go along. Just hopefully it doesn't rain at Deschambault.
Yeah, hopefully, that's right. And I know he's SMX is their track there, so I know he's going to have some people, some pros. If you're in the area, don't just show up at SMX. Get in touch with Jeremy Mackay. Find him there on his Instagram. Find him there and talk to them, and maybe you can go get some practice riding in during the week if you're looking for a place and you're watching this. 77, how about Casey Keast? Man, that race today.
Yeah, my Husky Pack teammate, Casey Keast. Yeah, I'll take full credit for that one. No, I'm just kidding. Casey killed the start, like just crushed it, and was just finding another gear, and he was super, super solid. He was, I think at one point, not taking anything away from Jess. I think, Jess was kind of backing down a little bit, did have a big lead, but Casey was reeling him in at one point. And he looked awesome. I think this is what he really needed, as well as the Carlson Racing team and Husqvarna Canada. So I think that's the first podium for the team.
Yeah, I guess maybe I'm not 100% sure, but
he said that in his interview. Watch it.
Oh, there you go. So there you go. Yeah, but he looked great. He stayed in second for the longest time. He had Jake Piccolo. There's three BC boys: Pettis, Piccolo, and Casey up front there. So that was kind of cool to see. I think Casey stalled it actually, and then Jake got around him, kind of thing, and lost that spot for second. Wasn't able to duplicate it in the final moto, but it still gave him 8th overall. So congratulations to him and the Carlson Racing team there. So ahead of him, 123, Ryan Surratt. Just kind of out there. I mean, I kind of expected a little more, from him sometimes out there.
Pretty quiet today.
He was
pretty
quiet.
I think he didn't really get a great start. Any motos that I saw today, and he just kind of moved around and shuffled back forward a little bit, and then ended up where he needed to be. So it's a quiet day, but I wouldn't be bummed down on that either. So.
No, for sure. Okay, and while we're speaking of him and the Sky Racing team, troubles for number 92, his teammate Richard Taylor. Another mechanical DNF. I mean, he's just kind of struggling to get his feet going here, and sounds like he's going to actually be heading home and won't be showing up at Deschambault with the team.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. It's, he's a U.S. racer, came up here. He is a big dude on a 250F. He's not a big, square kind of guy, but he's very, very tall. So he's obviously
he's not skinny. You know,
he's not skinny at all. So there's a lot of weight there, and you know, with the conditions we've had this year, with everything being super deep and pretty wet too, it's
asking a lot of a 250F.
Yeah, it's asking a lot. So I mean, it's nothing against the equipment. I think it's just unfortunately the meshing of the two.
Yeah, for sure. So we just wanted to mention that. It's kind of a little note there, yep. In the 250 class. Ahead of him, you call him the diesel.
I call him the diesel. I don't know if I don't really call it to his face, but Hayden Hollestead, number 30.
Sideshow diesel.
He is the guy that's running it in on guys at the end of the moto, super consistent, you know, rocking the handguards every moto. I think that's kind of cool, very Euro of him with the long hair. And he's just, you know, he doesn't falter near the end. Doesn't get the greatest of starts, but I always look for him at the end of the moto.
I like to think of him as the, he's kind of the Liam O'Farrell of the 250 class. He's not South African.
No.
He doesn't have kids.
No, it's true.
He's not the same number, doesn't ride the same bike.
I do call Liam the diesel too, so it's one of those things.
I gotta be more original. All right, at him. Bit of a surprising weekend. Didn't have the weekend that he wanted. Number 19, Marshall Welton.
Yeah, I called him for the first moto today. I said right to you, and I said, you know, I think he's gonna do well, and just couldn't seem to get off the gate. That seemed to be the issue. Just couldn't seem to get off the gate, so I think that's what happened. And with being one line track at times, it's just hard to pass, and he was going fast, super fast, but just unfortunate.
Right, yeah, and I again watched the interviews, we spoke with him, and he's going to work on starts this week too, so watch for him to come out swinging at Deschambeau. Ahead of him, man, great, finally got out there, like we said, 2-2, I think even 16-2-2.
Yep.
Talking about Jake Piccolo here for fourth overall, two podiums there, ended up on the overall podiums. Pretty cool to see.
Yeah, great kid, and it's good to see him kind of come into his own a little bit too, because it seemed like he'd get good starts this year, and then he'd just end up on the ground. He always seemed to be missing a visor or something of the case, or a twisted bike, and I think that's going to come with age, and he's going to get better as he goes along. So it's good to see that, and I'm sure he was really happy. You know, I went over to interview him after the race, and he was kind of surprised. It was like nice. I think one of his first real times being interviewed, obviously as a pro. So it was good.
Yeah, for sure. And I mean, sorry, I said overall podium. I mean, he was on the second and two and three moto podiums. But yeah, that second moto, I'm wondering if it'll show in the video. I'm not sure if you saw it on TV too. His back wheel was wobbling up and down. So I thought, oh no, something's coming apart in the back end. I didn't know what was going on. I thought he had a flat maybe. They couldn't find out what was wrong with it. Went back out, third moto, it was fine. Didn't do it. But they're having some other motor issues. Bit of smoke coming out of the pipe early.
Yeah.
They were quite concerned that he wasn't going to make it, but held on, man. It looked really good. So that's the performance we've been waiting to see out of Jake Piccolo for the past couple of years. I mean, yeah. He's been a highly touted amateur coming up.
Good for him. No, nothing but positive things to say about him.
Breaking into the podium, this is getting pretty familiar. Third place, 46, Marco Canella. Marco Canella, what do you say?
Mr. Consistency, number three, third overall. I know it's probably bugging Kale and KT and those guys saying, hey, like, we need one more spot. We need two more spots because, you know, he's right there. But the guys in front of him are definitely earning it. And Marco is not, I wouldn't say the best of the rest, because he's definitely earning those podiums, and he's a guy that's really, really super solid. He's coming to his own this year, and it's great to see it. I always like to send Kale a text after the weekend, his mechanic Kale, saying, you know, congrats on the podiums and whatnot. It's becoming pretty regular, so.
Nice. Now, and for sure, I mean, we've been waiting for years to see this. I mean, ahead of him is Tanner Ward. I mean, Marco, Tanner came up together, and then Jess, another young kid coming up. I mean, the young kids are taking over in that class for sure. Number 18, Tanner Ward, finished second overall. What can you say about that, you think?
Super solid. You know, it seemed like he just, I don't know if it was starts or what it was. I know he was battling with Piccolo pretty hard in the final moto. So, you know, it came right down to the last few corners.
He really put a press on him.
Yeah, he did.
So some lappers in there too. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, lappers were another issue again with it being so one-lined. But Tanner really wanted it. It was not from lack of trying. So, it's just that's racing. And Piccolo, got pretty lucky. Not pretty lucky, but he got the better end of the luck, I'd say, for the day. So, sure. Yeah, a good ride for Tanner all around.
All right. Yeah, and these guys are becoming very familiar and getting used to being on that podium, which we've all, again, expected from years past to see it, and it's kind of cool to see it actually happening now.
Yep.
And then taking the wins, he went 1-1-1. Jess Pettis was the man out there.
Yeah, Jess is a great, I said this before we hit record, I said I don't really have much to say, because he whole shot, I think, every moto, all three of them, and was gone. And I made a joke. I said he was cleaner at the end of the third moto than he was when he started it, because I watched him walk around his gear afterwards, and he was spotless. I'm sure Matt didn't even have to pressure wash the bike, just rolled back in the truck. The thing was, you know, the track was good. He was flying. So, yeah, it's what can you say? Jess is in absolute control.
Right. So, for sure, he extended his points lead. He had 22 going into this weekend. He's extended it there because Marsha was back in fifth. So, So pretty interesting to see. We got one more round of motocross, and we head to the four rounds of supercross. Little notes, I guess we want to talk, we mentioned Richard Taylor already, yep. And Quinn Amiot.
Quinn, pretty regular in the top 10 this year for sure. Had an unfortunate DNF, looks like a bike blew up final moto, and I saw him walking back, and you know, Quinn's a very good kid, very polite, and still, you know, had time to chat and to say, yeah, bike blew up, bummer, and you know, was, you know, could have been in way worse shape, so he's, it's a bummer for sure, because he's been really solid, he was riding really well, and I saw him at one point just absolutely charging, goggles off, dirt in his eyes, and just second moto just gunning it. So it's unfortunate, but that is racing. So
he might be the guy that I can tell who it is from the farthest away.
Yeah, I can see that.
That riding style.
Yeah, he's a big, tall kid, and he's he stands up a lot, and he does charge pretty hard. He's doing really well, so it's really great to see Quinn. He'll be back, and I'm sure his mechanic slash brother Benny will. Have that bike pretty dialed coming to Deschambeau.
That's right. If you watch also, we interviewed him. He and Bennett are living in their van this week and stuff there, past, so it's they're having a good time.
Oh, geez.
And no matter where they went over there, they seem to be in the mud. He just couldn't get that sprinter van out of the mud over there.
No.
But anyway, okay, so man, that does it for Sandalee for the 250 class, right? So thank you very much to Sneaky Weasel, and thanks for checking it out. Watch for the highlight show coming up.
Cheers, guys. Cheers.